the deaths on the roads so far this year, 54, and I think that's shocking, really, when you consider that the reduction in traffic that has taken place on our roads, and I think it should be said an awful lot more. In relation to that, you said also as well that the drink driving and drug driving tests are increased significantly, and the amount of people being captured is increasing significantly. And I'm just wondering, is that because of the number of Garda checkpoints that are out there, is it that there's more enforcement now rather than maybe more drink driving taking place? And that, I think that would be very interesting to hear your views. The rural transport and the rural transport companies. The NTA, as you know, have maintained the funding at 100% for the rural transport companies, and I think that's very welcome and very, very encouraging of them to do that. But with the social distancing requirements as they move into the new phases, I think they'll only have a 23% capacity in the existing buses that they have in the rural transport. So that's going to be hugely reduced capacity. And I'm just wondering, does your plans include anything to increase that and to increase that capacity on them? And also then, just your talk about masks and hand washing in terms of the flights and stuff like that there, and buses, will that also apply to the rural transport? And will funding be provided for them to provide for the masks and hand washing as well when they go onto the bus and use the service? Thank you.
First one is the deaths on the roads. I agree with you. It is disappointing, and I'm not sure whether I'm going to answer your question, because I agree with everything you say, I think, so it's a bit difficult to answer to it. But yeah, it is disappointing that in the circumstances that when there's so little traffic on the roads, that the road deaths have gone up. And the explanations are difficult to understand. Obviously, the statistics very sadly show that a huge number of pedestrians are being killed. And it's difficult to actually connect that with the fact that there are less cars on the roads. But the evidence, obviously, is that drink driving is still going on, and the drug driving is still going on. It may well be that there are more people being convicted and being caught because of there being more guardy on the road. The RSA, I know, are looking into this, and they're going to report to me shortly about it and saying why they think this is happening, because it is almost inexplicable when traffic's down about 70%, the deaths are going up. And it's something we should certainly find out. The only indications are that there are a lot more people out and walking, and a few more of them are very sadly getting killed. But that doesn't explain bad driver behaviour. So I don't know at the moment, but we will get an answer to that, I think, fairly shortly, because we would expect the figures to be low. The rural transport companies. I think that you're right about that. Social distancing is going to be as challenging. It's going to make it as challenging. There as it is in Dublin, and you know, the buses, single-decker buses, I think that the maximum number of people you can take in it is 12, and in double-decker it's 17. And so you're talking about a situation where there are challenges, but the determination is there, I think, in all cases, to meet the capacity wherever it's possible. And they're certainly aware of it, and they're making the arrangements, which may be necessary. It is a bit of a difficult question to answer, because we don't exactly know what the demand is going to be. We don't know what the demand is going to be in any areas for public transport or for rural transport in the coming weeks and months, because we don't know how many people are going to be frightened of going on in the bus and go to their cars. We don't know how many people are going to be working from home. But they're monitoring very closely, and they're very confident the first phase will be all right, and they'll monitor to see how that goes and adjust accordingly.